Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha. This is Jeebs here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge, dissecting your favorite tracks suggested by you. Now I'm going to be doing Opeth, Window Pane. Opeth has been a wonderful journey for me on this channel. I think I've done about four or five, or this will be number five. I also did one on Patreon too. That was absolutely amazing. I love this style of prog rock. It's the Porcupine Tree. And, you know, it's that whole vibe and that whole era of composition that I really love to gel to. And I've got all kinds of rock here on this channel, but something about Opeth is one of those kind of gummy bear type of hangout listen sessions, if you know what I mean. Anyhow, I want to thank you guys like usual for your support. The shoulder is getting a little better now, thankfully so. You want to show me a little love, buy me a cup of coffee, because you know that these reaction videos don't bring any monetization, even if you see advertising. Link will be below. Link will be below for the headsets, for my Patreon. Even just check out the Patreon, see what I've done on there. Even if you just drop in for a month, you know, and grab all the content and bail. Super cool beans. All right, guys, let's do this. Opeth, Window Pane. All right.
Disappears and returns again, counting hours, searching the
You know, for me, there's I'm gonna hang on to your hat here for a second, because I'm gonna say a little bit here. First and foremost, the organic process of recording this track is so evident in the nuances of the performance. That was a lot of words. Just to say, I love the fact that the feeling that I'm getting reminds me of the old days in the 70s and the 80s recording in a studio, and allowing the nuances of string noises, finger noises on strings and stuff like that to be a part of the composition in the arrangement. It's just the, you know, it just reminds me, also in my head, I just like envisioned back in, you know, when I was an engineer in North Hollywood, there was a place called Studio Sound, and there was a two-room studio, and all of a sudden I just envisioned all the mics set up by the amps and the kit. Everything. It's a warm, fuzzy, analog feeling, if you know what I mean. Not saying that I know that this was done in analog or not. It just gives me that feeling. Okay, so let's talk about the guitar work in this. I love the voicings and the chords that they're using to play, leaving it very wide open so that these, like, kind of, soulful harmonics can ring through slightly. I mean, it's that feeling of wide and ambient when you have voicings like that, which are these more dynamic intervals in a chord. You have options, you know, for those of you who are not musicians. Listen to the bass on this. What wonderful bass playing. I mean, so far it's been more of an instrumental expose to me that I've heard, you know, on this, because I guess we're about to go back into another vocal, but they've been treating us more to to the journey through instrumentation, you know, through the musicianship and stuff. This is not obviously a typical song structure, you know, intro, verse, hook, or pre-chorus turnaround. They're taking us on their own journey. And the fact that they're glamming more on the making sure that we get into the groove and the essence of the composition and the arrangements is what's just outstanding to me about this whole thing. But I'm in a really good space. You know, opening this, you know, doing this track, first of all, I'm in a good mood today. And then this just put me into a full glide mode, just kind of drifting over the clouds and just chilling, but really enjoying the musicianship and the composition on this. All right, let's keep going.
Might be waiting for someone. Might be there for us to see. Might be in need of talking. Might be staring directly at me.
I was going to start to mention something about engineering, but this one really exclamated my stop. I want to start with what we just heard is that, you know, the melody on this has been very subtle, but really nice intervals. You know, a lot of moving around in the melody. But I want to say simple. Remember, simple is not easy. There's not a lot of stuff happening here. It's just unbelievable how this melody, it's wonderful how this melody swims around the voicings of the guitars. Now for the engineering is what I earlier said about the bass, and the reason why the bass is really standing out for me is where it's positioned in the mix. Isn't necessarily that it's pushed more forward that I can pick it up, but the space in the engineering that's allowing the bass to live in that pocket right in the middle is because of the engineering and the left and right presence of the picking guitar, or it could be plucking or picking or... Now, whether or not that it's a, it sounds like it's a clean electric, and, you know, there's various ways that you can actually get a one-pass recording in stereo. It's miking techniques, or maybe one line direct, you know, through a DI, and then another one, you know, mic'd, or two mics, depending on the cabinet, you know, and each mic might be different. You know, a mic will be set over here, and this one might have a higher more of a mid response to the signal, and, you know, a different mic here, and then you can go hard left and right on it. But what we just heard with this really nice melody that he was singing, it was very nice. There's barely any reflection or effect on his voice. But do you notice on the last note that he hung on before he went out into this? And I'll go back and we'll listen to it. You'll hear how the engineer brought up the return, probably through the return, if it was an automated move, of a long hall or cathedral kind of sound, and it just glides, even though he stops singing, that reverb just glides. And it's almost like I said, oddly enough, like I said earlier, it's like a glider response to me. Truly, that's how it feels like, just flowing. And that's just what it's giving me, you know, in here. But let's go back a little bit and we'll just listen to that last note. Listen to how there's barely any, if any, effect on his voice, and on that last note out, how it swims out. So let me see if I can bring that here. Okay, here we go. Okay, I know we're about to get into solo. I'm so sorry for stopping there because I'm starting to glide with this again. You know, one of the things, two things I want to mention. That passage, I think it was 16 bars of the dun, 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 that bottom movement that was going on with the guitar. But what I found compelling about that whole passage is that there are two open notes that are being played as part of that plucking pattern. And even though the bass is the bass of the, you know, the bass and it, I think it's the in unison, the bass of the guitar is going dun, 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 whatever. I obviously don't have the pattern. But what really makes that stand out is the pedaling of these two notes that are still in that plucking configuration. You know, so those are those constant, and that's kind of like that zip line, that joy line of like giving me something to hang on to through it, you know, kind of a safe zone while the bass is making those just great changes and stuff. That's wonderful. Something else that I haven't said anything about now until now is there seems to be kind of a string type pad behind it, and it's not a really fat sound. And what I mean is like hard left and right and stuff like that. Now it could be live strings, but it's in a width of about here in the back that I really like. But the other thing that I'm really enjoying, and what we just heard maybe in the last couple minutes, I'm sorry, last 30 seconds, is they allow us to settle into a super melodic groove that in of itself, let's just say without a lead melody, be it instrumental or vocals, it's written so well that you could just sink into this just vibe of what they're playing. You know, any singer or musician that has lead capabilities could listen to that phrase and pick up their instrument or, you know, free sing a beautiful melody over what was just done there. But to let it be in of itself is, as far as I'm concerned, is probably some of the most beautiful type of composition where there isn't so much happening. But when written and composed and arranged in this nature, it could just do as much soul settling emotional response than having to add more to it, i.e. a singing melody or a lead guitar melody. Just these really nice patterns and stuff that they were playing here, and it's really super cool. All right, I'm gonna try to not say another thing for the rest of this track, and we'll get out of here. Thank you. Too bad that's the end. What a bummer. I was just getting so into that just now. You know, a couple more things I want to say and then fade out here for me. The melody was beautiful. The singing was fantastic. The harmonies in there were so beautiful yet unsettling, because some of the harmonies did not release the tension or the suspension of where they were hanging in their harmonies. Instead of resolving it or something, it left you hanging and dangling. And also the, you know, the two notes that are being played, kind of what I was calling the pedaled notes before that, it has a very unique dissonance to it as well. So this is a song to me that evokes for me is this kind of pensive gliding, kind of the comfort of being and being above and around and just kind of zooming and just kind of chilling. But yet, you know, just because it's beautiful and clear, you never know if you don't hit every now and then some clear air turbulence, kind of a vibe to it, you know. Of course, I don't listen to the lyrics on my first time around. It's always about the melody and the performance of the vocals. This might be one of those songs that I go back to. And then the last thing I want to say is the intimacy of the engineering on the drums is fantastic, because there's so much beautiful ambient composition that are there. So notes that are holding for their full, you know, value. Even if it's a quarter note or a half note, holding for its full value and stuff. There's a lot of long going on, which means that there's also a lot of ambient energy in the tails of these, you know, guitar structure and the bass holding notes as well. So there's this, and remember the reverb on that one little section I talked about, but the drums are nice and tight and a very light reflection, like a room and stuff. So it really, without it having to be over pushed in the mix, just by virtue of it being a tighter sound, by not having any real reflection or reverb on it, really pierces for me. Not pierces out of control, but from an engineering point of view, it's so wonderful. This is such a wide song that glides and drifts, but yet this drum, sound in engineering, gives it this grounding feeling. And I don't know, that's just how I feel like I'm explaining it right now. It could be because I'm on my second cup of coffee. But anyhow, thank you so much for hanging out. This was a long one, but so well worth it. And obviously, if you're an Opeth fan, I'd love to hear if anything I said may resonate with you, or maybe how does this song make you feel, if it's the same kind of way or something completely different. We all hear music differently. Remember that. There isn't really one way to listen to it just because I say this doesn't mean that it is so. Yeah, something like that. Anyhow, so thank you very much. This is just, I was in a great mood and wanted to drop one more today before the day ended. And so Opeth Windowpane was the one I do. Thank you so much. If you see so fit, if you want to support me in the channel, buy me a cup of coffee. The link will be down below. The link will be down below for the Patreon, the headsets, and also Opeth Spotify. All right, guys, take care. Aloha. All right. We'll be right back.